جزاك الله خير. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على محمد وآله وصحبه وسلم. First of all, I would like to take the opportunity to thank the Imam of Masjid Ibn Abbas and the administration. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant them success. And I would like to thank you as a community for giving me the opportunity to share some benefits with you in regards to the topic that we're going to discuss tonight, inshallah ta'ala, is actually the most important topics of them all. The most important topic in this seminar. Because it has to do with the affair of manhaj. It has to do with the affair of manhaj, methodology. And you heard in the khutbah, I mention the hadith of the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam when he said that my ummah will be divided into 73 sects, all of it will be in the fire except one. They said, which one is this, O Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? There are two narrations. One of them, he said, hiya al-jama'ah, it is the main body. And the main body doesn't necessarily mean that it is a big group of people. A main body can be one person. When al-Imam Abdullah ibn Mubarak, rahimahullah ta'ala, he was asked about al-jama'ah, what is al-jama'ah? What is the main body? He said, Abu Hamza Sukkari. And those who are with him. Abu Hamza is one imam, from the imam of the Salaf. So he called him main body. Because the main body is the one who is upon the truth. The one who is upon the truth. And whoever is with him, they are considered al-jama'ah. Not like some people may understand this affair, that al-jama'ah has to be a big number of people. Not necessarily so. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran, He condemned the majority. He condemned the majority. Allah said in the Quran, وَإِن تُطِعْ أَكْتَرَ مَن فِي الْأَرْضِ يُضِلُّكَ عَن سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. If you were to obey and follow the majority of the people on the earth, they will mislead you away from the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the real consideration is not in numbers. The real consideration is following the truth and being upon it and being with those who are upon it. This is the solution and this is the way to salvation. And understanding the Salafi manhaj. Who are the Salaf? This is a very important question. And what is the Salafi manhaj? And is it obligatory for all of us, every Muslim and Muslima, to follow the Salafi manhaj? Yes, it is obligatory. Yet it is obligatory. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nisa, first of all, we're going to learn the ruling. Is it highly recommended to be on the Salafi manhaj? Or is it mandatory to be on the Salafi manhaj? Do you have to, fard? Or is it highly recommended, or you don't have to be on it? Or you could just call yourself Sunni, or you can call yourself Muslim, and that's it. And then you move with the flow like that. It doesn't work like that. We have guidelines. The Sharia has guidelines. What did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala say about this affair? So that we would know the ruling from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because al-ilm, as al-Imam ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said al-ilmu qala Allahu qala rasuluhu, qala as-sahabatu ul-irfani. Al-ilm is what Allah said and His Messenger said. And what the companions, those who were given knowledge, what they said. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah An-Nisa, He said, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, the meaning of which, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ, whoever contends with the messenger, whoever opposes the messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى, after the guidance has been clarified to him. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as al-Imam Muhammad Nasir Din al-Albani rahimahullah ta'ala mentioned, he said Allah could have said, نعم, He could have said, it would have been enough to say, whoever opposes the messenger after guidance has been clarified to him, we will leave him in that path that he had chosen and we will land him in the hellfire. But Allah did not stop there. He added something extremely important for this lecture. It's a very important ingredient in this lecture. And that's why we keep saying, we understand the Quran was Sunnah with the understanding of who? Salaf al-Salih. The understanding of the Sahaba, radiyallahu anhum wa ardahum. And then he said after that, وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. This is the point of reference. And it follows a way other than the way of the believers. Of the believers. Okay, now, in the Arabic language, and this is a great benefit in usul al-fiqh, in usul al-fiqh, in the principle of jurisprudence, okay? You have al-am. Al-am is that which is general. Al-am is that which is general. For example, when you say al-ma' water, this is am or not? Am, water. Any water can be included in this statement. But when you say zamzam water, is this am or khas? Is it specific? Specific. Now, he said, وَيَتَّبِعْ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, and it follows a way other than the way of the believers. Is the believers general here or not? المؤمنين. Is it عام or خاص? عام, right? It's general. Okay. But it is intended to be what? Specific. This is العام الذي يراد به الخصوص. العام الذي يراد به الخصوص. Translation. This is the general that is intended to be specific. Okay? An example of that. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-An'am, He said about الشرك الذين آمنوا ولم يلبسوا إيمانهم بظلم أولئك لهم الأمن وهم مهتدون. Those who believe and did not mix their iman with dhulm. What is dhulm? Oppression. طيب. Okay, is the word dhulm in this ayah general or specific? Huh? Who said general? Who said specific? Specific. All of you agree specific. Okay, what is it? What? Shirk. Major shirk. Okay. So how did we know that? From where? How did we understand that it is specific? From where? From, but who explained to us? Did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mention in the Quran in another ayah that explained that ayah that it is major shirk? Or did the sunnah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam clarify that to us? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he clarified that to us. طيب. Now, It is intended to be, even though it is general, but it is intended to be specific, like here in this ayah in Surah An-Nisa, وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولِ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعَ غَيْرَ سَبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ نُوَلِّهِ مَا تَوَلَّى وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. Whoever opposes the messenger, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after guidance has been clarified to him, and he follows a way other than the way of the believers, Mufassireen, they say the believers are the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim. You see? And he follows a way other than the way of the Sahaba, Ridwanullahi alayhim. Then what is the end result if he does not? Nuwallihi ma tawalla. This is a serious threat, wal'iyadu billah. It shows you that this matter is not something that is highly recommended and you could just shove under the rug and move on. La. This is fard upon all of us to follow the kitab, was sunnah, and the way of the sahaba, ridwanullahi ta'ala alayhim. We have no other choice. Because if we don't, the end result, nuwallihi ma tawalla, wal'iyadu billah. We will leave him in that path that he had chosen. وَنُصْلِهِ جَهَنَّمَ وَسَاءَتْ مَصِيرًا. And we will land him in the hellfire. And what an evil destination, وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ. It shows you the danger of this affair. So that's why following the Salafi manhaj is fard. Fard Ayn, not fard kifaya. You know the difference between fard Ayn and fard kifaya. Anyone knows? What is the difference between fard Ayn and fard kifaya? نعم تفضل. نعم. Yes. أحسنت. أحسنت. For example, is the Adhan فرد عين or فرد كفاية? The Adhan. Calling the Adhan. فرد كفاية is a community obligation. So one person should be designated to call the Adhan. That's it. What about غسل الميت? To wash the dead body, the deceased. Is it fard ayn or fard kifaya? Fard ayn or kifaya? Which one? Kifaya, ahsant. Okay, what about the salat, performing the five daily salawat? Fard ayn. Okay, here, following the sahaba ridwanullahi alayhim, according to this ayah, is it fard ayn or kifaya? Fard ayn. Huh? You see? It's you have to. Nobody can say, well, let's just follow other way. It's okay. No, la, 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 la. You can't cut corners here. You have to follow the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhim. Because how are you going to understand al-Islam without the understanding of the Sahaba? For example, al-Quran. Who explained al-Quran to us? Who did? The Sahaba, the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam and his companions. Like for example, Abdullah ibn Abbas, radiyallahu anhuma. The Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he made dua for him. He said, Allahumma faqihu fi ddeen, wa'allimu ta'wil. He said, oh Allah, grant him the understanding of the deen, al-fiqh, and teach him al-ta'wil, teach him the interpretation of the Quran. And that's why you find that Abdullah ibn Abbas, he had a school in Mecca. He had a school and he had students. Can anybody name some of the students from the Tabi'een, the student of Abdullah ibn Abbas? Anybody knows some of the students of Abdullah ibn Abbas? Naam. Naam, Mujahid ibn Jabr. You find, you know, like when you go to Tafsir ibn Kathir, Tafsir al-Tabari, okay, do you find the tafsir of Ibn Abbas there or not? You find it. Huh? And then you find the tafsir of who? The Tabi'een. The student of Abdullah ibn Abbas. Naam? So you find many of his students, Sa'id ibn Jubair, Mujahid ibn Jabr, and other than them, from the student of, why would they learn from the Sahaba? Why? Why would they could have sufficed by themselves. Could they have done that? La, they can't. You have to seek knowledge from the companions, Ridwanullahi alayhim. Why? Because the companions, they witness the revelation. They witness the revelation. And they are the one that documented the revelation for the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As you know, and some of you may not know, But this is just give you a history about how the Quran was